everybody, this is Cross from Vanguard. I'm ZaCaptain here. I got Dempster.
Hi!
And Suzuko Mimori.
Hi.
Okay, alright. So today we have for you a fight between Aqua Force and Angel Feather.
Mm-hmm.
I got nothing anymore. So we'll just go jump straight into dev profiles. Dempster, what do you and Mimori have?
What? Okay, that aside. What I'm playing now is the Thavas deck, which was previously featured in the fight with the Maiden of deck. So this one has a recent boost in GBT09 with a lot more wave related cards.
Alright.
And of course strikes. We are focusing more on Thavas this time round. So the reprints are back for Commander Thavas with Wheeling Thavas, etc. also. And actually, yeah, that's about it. So, Kat, what's your side?
Alright, today I bring to you...
Blau.
not Blau, but it's a different one. This is my Celestial deck. Alright, okay. So this one is a Celestial deck that's been boosted in GBT09 as well.
Mm-hmm.
Alongside with Gavro. So also I've got some of the other...
cheating skills.
Mm-hmm. Well, as you say, and I'll fail with the other strikes that go in there. Mm-hmm. Now, my great trees in this deck, right, plays around Zaracil. So that will be the Ace Vanguard for this. However, with Celestials, you can actually change up your great trees according to how you like. But more will be explained in the deck profiles, which you can check at the bottom. And at the same time also, at the description box below, there will also be links to our Patreon. Now, do consider supporting us over on Patreon because we are looking to start more bigger, more ambitious projects as well,
yep.
Such as a Vanguard web series. So we want to get that happening and you can help us make that happen faster if you support us through Patreon. So, with that said, let's get straight into the shuffle.
Let's go!
So, we're gonna ride the waves today.
Yes.
Kawabanga, dude.
So cool.
Is it Wednesday?
No.
Aww. It's not Wednesday, my dude.
At least it's not Tuesday.
The swell's still good, so.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Don't you mean money?
Can I redraw again?
Yeah, go ahead.
Because I got decked the same stupid things.
Mm.
I hate the sleeves.
Don't you mean money?
Stop!
Look, you worship your thing, I worship mine.
Yes. Much better.
Alright.
Right? Yeah.
So,
scissors, paper, stone.
Scissors, paper, stone.
Yeah, I'll go first.
Alright. Ready?
Yep.
Stand up, my finger.
So, I draw?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I go first. Okay, I'll write to Melania. And then I will call Mitros to the back. Send it.
Right, draw. Ooh, hi. Alright, emergency practices, I'll pull Gabriel behind.
Mm-hmm.
I'll take Evagat.
No guard.
Check.
Ooh, okay. Damage check, stand trigger. Nothing.
Right.
Okay, my turn.
Yes.
Draw. Alright, so Adelaide.
Mm-hmm.
No, not that one. So I'll attack.
So she's not a cheer girl, lah. So.
No.
Alright. No guard.
Okay, check. Nothing.
Check. Emergency Pegasus.
Mm.
Right, my turn.
Yep.
Draw.
Okay.
That's extra of you. So, right. To Makario.
Alright.
Attack your Vanguard.
No guard.
Check.
Okay. Damage check. Nothing.
Alright.
Okay. Stand and draw. Oh, hi.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Alright, to Taba. And then I'll call Pedros to the side.
Mm-hmm.
So then Pedros will attack 9k.
9k.
Yep.
82. What? No guard? Damage check.
Okay.
Critical trigger. I'm gonna fight into my Vanguard.
Okay. Makes no difference because I'll attack it with Thavas. Pedro skill. When my Vanguard attacks, when my Thavas Vanguard attacks, moving the soul. Draw one. Last 5k.
No guard.
Okay. Twin drive. First check. Heal trigger. I can heal.
Mm-hmm.
I'll heal one. Last 5k.
Mm-hmm.
Second check. Heal trigger. Cannot heal this time, but last 5k.
Alright. Damage check. Nothing.
I'm screwed.
Hey, you got guards for days.
Not the
you
point.
Got generation guards for days.
Not the point.
Bro. They suck!
Okay, yeah.
Not really that bad. Right, to Zaracil.
Mm-hmm.
And then I am going to strike.
Okay.
Into... Anafia.
Mm.
Right. So, no strike skill because this is not...
Uh-huh, bro. Very good.
Alright, but I'm going to call Bahariel. And I'm going to call Sario. Now, Sario's skill, when she appears in the Rigar Circle, I can counterblast one.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, then if I have an Angel Feather Vanguard, I can search my deck for any unit and put it into my damage zone face up.
Okay.
And then shuffle. And then later I'll choose a face up card and add it to the drop zone.
Add it to the drop zone.
put it to the drop zone. Hey, at least I'm not taking like technical issues just to realize what, just remember what the card does.
Fair enough.
Not like last time.
Fair enough.
Okay, so alright, so then I'm gonna activate Anafiel skill.
Mm-hmm.
Anafiel.
Can you do it?
Hang on. Before I do Anafiel skill, I will call another Baharia here.
Mm-hmm.
So then I'll activate her skill, which is actually it's a continuous skill. So as long as I have a Celestial Vanguard, Celestial Heart, then this unit gets the skill. I mean, active skill, so I may pay the cost, which is choose one of my Celestial Regards and put your damage zone face up.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Then what I do is that I choose one of my cards in the damage zone. Now face down or face up, doesn't matter.
Okay.
Okay. In this case, I think I will call...
Call Zaracil?
No. I will call Sama. I forgot what her name is. I'll call my critical trigger.
Okay.
Then I'll choose three units. In this case, I will choose Zaracil, Bahariel, and Sariel.
Mm.
And then for every face-up... For every face-up card that I have in my damage zone, all my Celestials get plus 3k. So I have... Baharia and Zaracil. So all my Celestials plus 6k.
Okay.
So 1, 2, 3, thank you. 4 and 5. Okay. Yeah. So it only gives to the all the Celestials that's currently in play. So when I call Halel, it doesn't activate.
Okay.
She doesn't get plus 3k because she wasn't there at the time.
Alright.
Although I could have called her, but I didn't realize that. Oh well. So, Hala will attack your Vanguard now. Now, Hala's skill, if I have a copy of my Vanguard in face up in the damage zone,
okay,
she gains plus 2k, and the skill, when this unit attack hits the Vanguard, I can counter charge one, soul charge one.
Counter charge one, soul charge one.
Yep, I still get the soul charge.
Okay, I'll take it. Damage check, kill trigger.
That's it.
Fuck
it. Okay.
yeah.
Alright, so, skill, counter charge, nothing, soul charge. Hello? Attack your Vanguard.
No go.
Right. First, critical. Critical, 5k.
Okay.
Alright. Second check. Third check, nothing.
Okay. First check.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Second check. 5 more.
Okay, I'll take your Vanguard.
Okay, generation guard.
Mm-hmm.
How big is that?
This is 8+5. 8 plus 5, 13, 19, 19 plus 13. 19 plus 13 is 32. So you need 20k, right?
20k.
You'll bring up to 36.
Okay, then I'll call
Flotilla.
And extra 5k.
Yep. It's only first or second wave then it gets the ability.
Yeah, that's a problem. That's a huge problem.
Yep.
Remember why I say they suck? Huh? Only balls then.
Alright.
Okay, my turn.
So, dice up.
Yep. Stand
up.
And roll. Okay, I'll strike. I'll strike to Commander Thavas. Now, Thavas strike skill. When my unit strikes, my Vanguard gets the skill. Now, fourth wave only, when my unit attacks the Vanguard, I choose three of my opponent's regards, and my opponent chooses one among them and retire it.
Alright.
Then in that case, I'm going to call Stasia. And I'll call Tidal Assault. And Adelaide. Adelaide skill, when she appears on the Vanguard circle, if I have a Thavas Vanguard, I may pay the cost, which is Thunder Blast 1 and Soul Blast 1. If I do, she gets plus 2k. And the skill. At the end of the battle, once a turn, I stand her.
Yep.
Okay. Then after that, that's about what I'm gonna do.
How about Commander Thavas skill?
Ah, yes, sorry about that.
Mm-hmm.
So, Commander Thavas skill, I'll flip one Commander Thavas over, which I keep forgetting. Okay, so I choose one of my rear guards during that turn plus 5k, and he gets the skill. Fourth wave only. He gets the skill, he can attack from the back row. And then, because I'm currently at 3v3 now, he also gets a skill. Fourth wave only, when my unit attacks with Vanguard, then choose three of my opponent's rear guards,
and
choose one of them, retire it.
Yeah, retire it.
So in this case, I'll choose Tasha plus 5k.
Alright.
Okay.
Yep.
Actually, you know what? Yeah, can I? Mm-hmm. Okay, go back. Alright. So, first of all, I'm going to attack with...
The Not Sure Girl?
Yes, the Not Sure Girl Adelaide to your Vanguard.
Alright, I shall intercept.
Okay. Then, end of battle, Then, after that, I'll attack your Vanguard.
Hello?
Yep.
Really?
Yes. Because I want to make her say bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay?
Okay.
Then I'll attack your Vanguard. This is 14 only.
Okay. Then... Okay. I'll take that. Damage check.
Okay. Then Magnum Assault skill. At the end of the battle, that this unit attacks the Vanguard. If it's boosted, I may pay the cost, which is 1 plus 1. If I do, stand him, plus 2k.
Alright.
So, plus 2.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'll attack your Vanguard again. Now, both Thavas skills will proc. So I'll choose this 3. You retire... Actually, you can retire 2 because...
Yeah, and then yeah, the 2 don't keep up.
Yeah. So this is 5k gun.
Alright. So, I will take that, let me check.
Okay. Alright. Then I'll tag with Thavas. This is 26.
Okay. Fanzang Guard.
Mm-hmm.
Just in case I need to strike, so I have to check. Keep it. So I'll
drop. You will need to strike, what are you talking about?
Yeah.
Okay. Triple drive. First check.
Oh, hi there.
Second check. Critical trigger.
Okay.
All effects here.
Oh! Okay.
Third check. Okay, nothing.
Alright.
And I forgot to use neutral skills, so whatever. Anyway. Alright. Then Stasha will attack. She has a skill of her own. Her continuous skill. This during my turn, this unit gets both skills. First skill, she can attack from back row. Second skill, when she attacks from the back row, plus 3k. So on her own, she's a 19k. Double crit.
Cut.
10k. Okay.
I actually forgot about Stasha, actually. Oh my god.
Okay. Don't you mean money?
Huh? You worship your thing, I worship mine.
Fair enough.
Okay. Then draw. Okay.
Before that.
Yep.
Hoi! Okay. Carry on.
Okay. I might be able to do this. It might be fun.
Go ahead.
Okay, I'll activate Baharia's skill from the damage zone, right? Which is at the start of my right phase, I can pay the cost, which is Soul Blast 1, and send this space up unit to the drop zone.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so then if I have a Celestial Vanguard, I may pay the cost, which I did. If I do, take the top card, put my damage zone face up.
Okay.
Alright, and then after that, choose my Vanguard and it gets the continuous skill. While you're paying the cost to strike all cards in your hand, plus 1 grade.
2 grade, isn't it?
2 grade, sorry.
Yeah.
Plus 2 grade. So, I'll drop the Grappier. Strike.
Very good.
Into... I think I know who to fetch already. Alright, into... For the Celestial Mikhail.
Okay.
Alright, I might not be able to get the 3 for the damage thing, but I can still do other things. Right, so then I will call... Zaracho here.
Okay.
Alright, then I'll activate Mikhail's skill. Call the last one.
Mm-hmm.
Then I will choose. Then after that, I choose. If I'm a Celestial Heart, I may pay. Then I choose one card, one face up card in my damage zone. Oh no, I put one card from the top of my deck into the damage zone.
Gotta make sure face up.
Yep. And after that, I choose one face up card in my damage zone and call it to a Rigard Circle. In this case, I will call Meheyao. Oh wait, there's no point in her already. So, yeah. Since that happened, I'll call hello.
Mm-hmm.
Hello, hello. Alright, then because I have a face up Zaracho, which is my heart currently, so this unit gets plus 5k.
Okay.
So,
nice.
It's a thing.
Yes.
So I will shall attack. This is 16 because of a skill.
16, eh?
Yep.
Okay. I'll guard and intercept.
Alright, attack.
Let's see, this is 26, right?
Uh-huh.
Generation Guard. Flotia. Flotia skill. When this unit appears in the Guardian Circle, if my opponent... This is the first or second battle, this unit plus 5k shield. So I'm currently at 31. That's 1. 3.
Drive. First, nothing. Second, nothing. I should go the other way just in case. Third, yes.
Okay.
Nothing. Nothing.
tick. Nothing. 10 sugar. No, it's not nothing.
Okay, sorry, now.
Okay. My turn?
Yep.
Stand. And draw.
This is where I die.
Yes. Final turn. Right? Here he comes.
Here he comes indeed.
You push me so hard, now I'll push you back equally hard.
You made me forget about Sasha, so I don't like you anymore.
You never like me, what are you talking about? Okay, I'll switch to Wailing Thavas.
Oh dear.
Okay, then strike skill, of course, Manega gets the skill now. And then after that, let's see, I can pull this off. I'll call Kratos,
I believe.
Kratos, whatever.
Kratos! No.
Shing! Okay, anyway. Okay, then after that, let's see. Actually, yeah, that's about it. So, what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to attack your Vanguard. This is 14k.
14k,
yep.
Got it.
Okay, then skill, come back one. Stand, plus 2k. I'll attack.
Give you?
Yes. Then after that, I will attack. Okay, this one can hit. Right. I'll attack your Rika.
Okay. I'll give you.
Okay. Then this one cannot hit. But Thavas skill will not activate. So I'll retire that one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Then I'll attack with Wailing Thavas. Wailing Thavas' first skill, his GB3 skill. When this unit attacks the Vanguard, for every rear guard that I attack,
mm-hmm.
okay. For every rear guard that has attack, so in this case 3,
mm-hmm.
my opponent retire 3. Okay, and then his other skill, kind of last one, the GB2 skill. When this unit attacks the Vanguard, for every rear guard that has attacked this turn, in this case 3 again,
uh-huh.
this unit plus 5k, so in this case plus 15, and my opponent cannot guard with grade 1. And then Mitro skill, okay, because this is the third wave and beyond, I'll use the skill when my Vanguard attacks, move him into Soul, search my deck for a Thavas, superior call it, so I will call over Man in Call.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then after that, at the end of turn, he will bounce back to my hand.
Talk about adding insult to injury.
I'm not done yet. Critter skill! Third wave, or third wave only, okay, never mind. whatever.
Look at.
Okay, first check, second check, third check, stand trigger, stand.
Last one again. Damage check. Draw trigger.
Oh!
I have not seen a heal ever in this match.
Do you know why? Cause all my heals came out. They all came to this side. I'm like,
so that's Barans ah.
Yeah, very Barans.
Very Barans page two. Only 4 heal triggers in one go. Yeah, all my heal triggers just at the bottom. So it's just a matter of how soon it will come out and when it will save me just in time. Actually, so.
Okay, just to prove it. Not a single heal trigger left.
Yep.
All 4 came out.
And as you can see from mine, 1, 2, 3, 4. All 4 of them are still in there, right? Yes. Although if for the sense of for my side,
mm-hmm.
I did have one Zaraka in my hand, but then I realized that there's no point in me, you know, guarding off because I know this is coming in the next turn already. So if I don't take him off, it's right there. So that's why I ended up using Bahariya's skill to sort of like use a skill so that I can strike with her. I'm dead in the next turn, so it's a matter of trying to fill up my field as much as I can.
Yep.
Which is why I had Holy Celestial Mikhail there. Mikhail actually helps with the reinforcement. Not as much, but she doesn't give as much power as Anafio would.
Yes.
But you, as you can see from that turn, Anafio can actually add power, massive power, to yeah. your entire field of Celestials, provided you have the setup for it.
And a maximum of 9k is enough.
And a maximum of 9k as well, so for every face up that you have.
Mm.
So, with Anafio is very, very good. However, you don't really need her that much, which is why I only played 2 of her, and then the rest are all
the cheating skills.
The rest of the cheating skills from a Gavro deck.
Yeah.
It's the same stuff that you saw that's in the
Gavro
bin.
Altiel, all this
just Gavro only because Gavro. She's the Gavro Rafael because they're the only ones that were in the that was on top of the trash bin in Bank of Ezekiel.
Yep.
So yeah, these were the cards that were there. I pushed them out back out. But yes, the good thing about Celestius is that I may play Zaraqiel, but I can change this to the Legion. I can change this to Ramiel as well. Mm. So the good thing about Celestius is that no matter what your grade 3 is, right, the rest of the deck does not have to follow suit that much. Yeah, I mean, Halal's already in there for the Legion already, so it's kind of helpful. So
mm-hmm. Right, then for this side, as you can see, The boost for GBT09 is pretty good, especially Willing Thavas and the reprint for Commander Thavas if you are playing a Thavas deck. Yep. But the problem is, even though they jacked up the number of wave cards here, they are not very, very useful. Which is the reason, which is why I still play things like Magnum Assault and Adelaide, etc, etc. The only reason why I play other things, despite them being not so good, like Kratas, Nikitas, or even... where is she? Or even Yanka. It's because Yanka herself requires as much rear guard with wave ability in the field as possible in order to proc a skill. Mm. And not only that, the Soul Blast cost is very expensive for a Thavas deck because there's literally very little way of soul charging other than using like Pedros or that grid 2 that allows you to soul charge, counter charge and soul charge, but only if the attack hits.
Mm.
Which it's very obvious that it will never hit anyway. Unless your opponent really sucked up,
like halal lah, halal, yeah, halal, halal.
Yeah. Oh. So in order to minimize the amount of soul blasting, and of course counter blasting as well, I try to keep the cards to a minimum. And the good thing is that Willing Thavas only requires one counter blast. Commander Thavas doesn't need any, and of course Thavas himself doesn't need any as well. So the whole deck, it depends on how you play it. Personally, I like to keep on pressuring my opponent with high attack every single wave, so that you know they throw more cards to guard. So. Mm-hmm. That's how the deck works.
Yeah. Right, so that's all that we have for you today. I hope you guys enjoyed the battle that we have for you. Well, that was funny for me to forget Star Shows. Yeah, that was absolutely funny. But that's how the thing is and how sometimes it works. So anyways, if you guys enjoyed the fight as much as we have, you can subscribe to us here at Crossover Vanguard for more shenanigans like this. You can see more fight videos that we put up for all of the as many decks as we can put up on this channel as much as we can. So at the same time, also do follow us on all of our socials. We're on Facebook at Crossover Vanguard. We're on Twitter at CrossoversVGS. And we also have a blog, CrossoverVanguard.com. If you want to see the deck profiles for this deck or you want to see deck profiles for this, you can check the links in the description below. They'll bring you to the deck profiles for this as well as some of the other ones that we've done previously.
Yep.
And as well some news of the things that we're doing around our stuff that we cannot do on this channel. So they'll be up on the blog as well. And lastly, of course, do check out our Patreon as well. As we said before the fight started, the Patreon, it is just as much for you guys as for us. And what we want to give to you guys is actually a Vanguard web series that I'm writing and we're trying to get produced.
Yep.
So any amount that you could pledge to us on Patreon, it will go towards funding this project that we really want to do. So if you want it to come and you're interested in what's going on with it, do consider supporting us on Patreon so that we can make it happen faster. That's just how it works also.
Yep.
I believe that's the term that no, I produce.
It works that way.
Alright, so with that said, thank you guys again for watching. We'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!